Ghost Hobbies. That's his color
day. Hey guys, how are you?
They're brown, yeah.
This is Stingray Reef. Good news, there's lots of jellyfish in at the moment. Stingers as a carrier. Game of chess. I think she'd be better off with drafts though, really. Don't get confused.
To the side.
Give us one of them prawns, I'm starving. I'm not chilling out before breakfast.
Green ants again, there they are, look, he's got some.
Very fertile around here. Hoping it's rock if it's ready and the sprouts straight away. This is the Dunk Island airstrip.
Something like that.
Not much to say.
Right, so for lunch.
Yes.
Oh, that plane looks like it's coming in. Now that's what you call calamari, stacked up high, big pieces. What's that, a bacon steak burger? Sand Island in the middle of a coral reef.
This is Coconut Reef Beach on Dunk Island. Perry's just gone out for a swim. No, you're not supposed to because it's stinger season still. But I know where the vinegar is if one gets him. What's this here?
There's the jellyfish vinegar station. Safety belt for when you get cramp.
Ha ha ha.
board skiing.
Set up somewhere, they're not clear. It's taking a snap. This is our budget hotel. Caravella. Backpackers. Dorms and small rooms, swimming pool, there's nobody in it. There were plenty in it at 3 o'clock this morning, making a night racket. Got communal kitchens, plenty of cookers. It's a bit early, nobody's up yet. Laundry, fridges. No noise after 11, my foot. That's our room, but it's, I don't know if I can get Janet's attention. Room's a bit dinky though. Could be self up. Look at size of room.
You don't do rooms.
I don't do rooms, but I do hutches. It's more like a hutch.
Shoebox, I call it.
Nice artwork, though. There's a bit more room because I've taken my pack out already. Janet's living out of a case because there's no wardrobes at all. Air conditioning, fridge, one strip light, one bed. That's it.
No hooks.
No hooks. And a view of the pool. They've got their own miniature bee nests. Look like little ants, but they're actually bees. Pulling it out, plants. Very noisy. Bats. It's a bat colony. Please, please, Louise, at the marina. Shangri-La. Marlin Wharf, that's where we're going to catch a boat at reef here tomorrow. Yes, they know how to do an English breakfast, and that's Janet's first egg on toast, and with her own Marmite of course. Yep, I'll be spending some money there.
There is a fair size. They've got cockroaches in best shops.
Oh dear. Yep. Look, I believe that's a convert palace cinema into travellers' accommodation. There's that many backpackers. It's on the mall. I'm not going to be here. Yeah, obviously, like, I mean, they've still got stuff to plug in here. The bombs. Not so much reflection. And there's a tow mucky. Some right kit for sale here. Oh yeah, I could spend a few hours in this shop. Not suitable.
No.
Oh yeah, I'm gonna have to spend an hour in here. That's our new hotel, Coral Tree. Is it the park? Coral Trees.
6 nights, no more shipping about now.
6 nights with a balcony over at pool. And we're just going about to go for a dip. But I'm videoing it just in case the sun never shines again. Look at this fern outside, straight outside the window. Beautiful.
Because there's a cyclone on its way.
There'll be no trees left shortly going by that cyclone. Yeah. Nice tropical garden.
Some little stubs.
Oh, we've had our free meal in the wool shed. Now there's a band on it in precinct. Why the busking? Are they busking these lot?
We've got a thing down, yeah.
Oh, they are busking now. Oh, yeah, that's a good photo. Brilliant mural. Typical Aussie evening.
Travis Morton takes three inside the 30 yards. Slow play the ball. Payne with a pass that was very tight. Body contact there between Scott King and Travis with the ball.
Oh!
Travis Morton by Ripley. And was waving the ball off. Here's Herman. Nice tackle. Matty Bowen screams through. Gets it. Kicks for 22 deep into the crowd. disappointed.
Yeah, it's not Bruce's fault. Bruce, not your fault.
Railway station, see how far we can get on railroad.
Ghost room, but I don't know what that is yet.
A ghost room? It sounds a bit sexy to me.
Cool.
Well, we found a railway station. Looks, it all looks a bit dead. No, Janet, it's on that side. That one's probably going to Brisbane. A load of Japanese. Finally to Corunda.
Magnificent views from this part of the line. If you look out toward the horizon, Stony Creek and Barrow Falls will be in the street. Thank you.
Yes, I've already got a cut of that. That was the first thing that I did in the station.
Seems of opal in that.
Good morning, how are you?
Great.
Thank you. That's good. Getting ready for our cyclone?
Oh, don't.
Don't even talk about it!
We were supposed to go out on the reef today, but it was cancelled.
Oh, what did they? Oh, they cancelled the reef. That would be just for security here.
Yeah, I thought they're overreacting a little bit myself.
Yeah, I do too. Bearty, may I show you?
Yes,
Bearty, this is the latest thing.
Different types of
opal. This is a cyclone off the internet this morning.
Oh.
I think they overreacted too. Here it is here. This is where it is at the moment. It's 7 a.m. this morning. Here you are, here Cairns. And... and this is expected to hit probably Innisfail below us at tomorrow, a.m. tomorrow.
Oh, so it is actually coming this way direct.
Yes, yes. But, I mean, how can they predict that it's going to go straight?
No.
Oh, no way.
Yeah.
And that's the Opal Mine, which reminds me a lot of Briggs's Quarry.
Severe tropical cyclone Larry, category 3, with central pressure 965 hectopascals centered in the Coral Sea, near latitude 17.6 degrees south and longitude 152.1 degrees east, which is about 680 kilometres east of Cairns. The cyclone is expected to intensify further and move in a general westerly direction at about 25 kilometres per hour over the next 24 hours. The centre of tropical cyclone Larry is likely to be near the Queensland coast tomorrow morning.
Video, not a camera. St. Saviour's Church. Let there be light. Amy O'Reilly's Bar and Grill.
9 is, you know, half a minute sail to come this way. A minute sail on Carville. Get out of the ball. Well, they say you're in the morning, they said it's like 9 o'clock or something tomorrow morning.
So, what does that mean with the airport? What do they usually do?
Tonight, one of the most powerful cyclones in decades is bearing down on the North Queensland coast. Severe tropical cyclone Larry may intensify to a Category 5 before crossing the coast between Innisfail and Cardwell tomorrow morning. The Queensland government has declared a disaster situation as some island resorts and coastal communities evacuate. By the time it reaches the coast, it's expected the storm will have wind gusts nearing 300 kilometres an hour, making it as strong as Hurricane Katrina, which lashed New Orleans last year.
By this evening, Cyclone Larry was still intensifying, with wind gusts over 250 kilometres an hour at its centre and heading quickly for the coast.
We're going to have an impact on the North Queensland coast tomorrow morning, the like of which we haven't seen for decades.
The cyclone's eye is expected to hit hardest between Innisfail and Cardwell.
Serious threat to life and property in the warning
area. Lots of big furniture.
6:30 a.m. Eastern Standard Time this morning. Severe tropical cyclone Larry, Category 5, with central pressure of 915.
It's stripped all trees out here.
The north tropical Queensland coast. Near latitude 17.6
degrees. We're miles from it.
Longitude 146.2 degrees east, about 20 kilometres east of Innisfail. The cyclone is expected to continue to move in a general westerly direction.
They're protected in here, but it's stripping all trees. That would have full tree of it here, bro.
A very destructive core of severe tropical cyclone Larry with extreme gusts of approximately 290
kilometres
winds is moving onto the coast in the Innisfail area. Destructive will be significantly above the normal tide, with damaging waves, strong currents and flooding of low-lying areas extending some way inland. Severe tropical cyclone Larry will move further.
The branch just gone. Both nearly full of branches.
Larry will move between Innisfail and Mackay.
Yeah, you couldn't see that roof before. Look at the state of it now. We're in a protected area, I don't know what it's like outside. All them lot have come off today.
Ooh. What,
the whistling at their buildings over? No, well, I'm glad we're not in those little flimsy backpacker places that have blown to bits. This wind's something solid. There she is, all dolled up. Ready to go out.
God, we're going to look right in this sticks here.
Look, they're having a big clean up. Great pull up already. It's 1:30. We'll see what's happening downtown. All dolled up for the casino. Well, Bowens is still standing. Yeah, it stripped that tree good and proper. All awnings come down, with wind. Clearing up going off. Yeah, there's plenty of windfalls. Windfalls, cyclone falls. Palm leaves all over, branches all over the road. Yeah, it's got a bit of power to snap them, hasn't it? Yeah, that one's keeled over. Little doves are doing well with windfalls. Setting that tree out. Ah, well, that took mother root out as well. Thank you. Casino aren't blown away then. Oh, that's handy. West palms are down. But that snapped clean off. Look, casinos had to bag its doors up. And them bags are full of notes.
Chips.
Full of chips. Look, that's what I'm after, winning them on jackpot.
All three.
We're in there for breakfast. So are you enjoying your drink? Oh, somebody's got the jackpot, I can hear it in the background. Bloody hell, it does sound like a good win. It's a bit early yet, the roulette tables aren't kicked off. This is what I like about it, they've even got racing in. A bit of wind outside getting up. You can see it through that. Oh yeah. Yeah, it's flattened a load of trees around Marina. That one's down. That one's down. Path blocked.
Got Psycho Larry's
gone. Psycho. Oh, that's a big one. Talk about opposites. Freemasons there. And then on that corner, there's a hostel called the Asylum. Asylum, full of nutters. And there's the biggest nutter. Oh, there she is. That was our first room in Cairns, in this hostel. As it didn't blow down last night. Well, they've had some leaf drop. Parakeets are roasting. See if I can zoom in at, and there's tons of them. There's the scout hut with the scout hat on top. The park outside our. There's quite a few branches and things broken down off the trees. Cleared most of it by now. Yeah, we didn't do too bad in Cairns. And that's our hotel there.
Service officers and police use special disaster powers to compel many residents to leave their homes and spend the night in shelters.
Our first officer said, well, you know, if you don't go, the police will come and drag you out. And I said, oh!
The cyclone was declared Category 5 shortly before it hit the coast early this morning. And those who remained in their homes witnessed the full force of Larry's fury.
He's going to take me photo.
Yeah.
Oh my God, this is terrifying. It's just about to stop. It's gone down. I've got windows out, windows broken, trees down, garage doors gone, fences down.
My mum has my son underneath the bed. We have mattresses covered all over them, and my dad is holding one of the windows shut. That's the room that they're in.
The mayor of Johnston Shire, Neil Clark, says the town is devastated.
Looks like an atomic bomb hit the place. It's severe damage. It's more than a local area can handle. I think it will even stretch the state to be able to handle this one, and we will be calling on national resources.
Fortunately, there have been few reports of injuries.
No fatalities that we're aware of at this stage. We're absolutely astounded at the low injury rate.
Darwin in 1974, Queensland Weather Bureau's senior meteorologist, Mike Bergen, says Cyclone Larry was less dangerous. But that's little consolation for the 100,000 North Queenslanders without electricity this evening, or the thousands who can't return home. And farmers face crop losses of more than $300 million. For Queensland Emergency Services officers and the residents of North Queensland, the work has only just begun.
It's tragic for the whole community. Being a tourism town, it's terrible. And a farming town, the sugar and bananas have been absolutely wiped out.
The complete destruction right through Innisfail. On top of the hill, I know that yesterday live on air that we were talking to a lot of people.
Oh yeah, we've got that church.
The church, there's the church on the top of the hill. The back of the building has just been blown out. A little hard to see from this particular angle. But everywhere you turn, every single building has some level of damage involved, whether it's the roofs ripped off, that the roofs caved in, walls have been blown out. Of course, no power is a major problem. You can tell why when all the transponders and all the power units are all destroyed, power lines for hundreds and hundreds of kilometres are either snapped in half or the wires are down. Windows just don't exist in this town anymore. With last night's heavy rain, not only were people forced to live without a house, without a roof, but also the rain, just to rub salt into the wound.
Now look at that. That won't get blown over in a wind, will it? Well anchored down. What's the fuel leaves like? Just have a pan round here because Janet's just found the North Indian Curry House, which is our favourite kind of Indian curry. Where she go? Oh yeah, Sandori oven. You don't mess about, do you? Bad news. No kingfisher.
New owners, your license hasn't been transferred yet, so you have to go to BYO.
Oh, that means I have to go to the bottle shop, which is an off license to us. I better go over there then, somewhere. And there's the bottle shop. Bottle Mart. Oh yeah.